Yes. Namaskar. Welcome to Indira Gandhi National Open University Facebook Lab. I am Dr. Palla Venkatramana from the discipline of Anthropology, School of Social Sciences. Today, we shall be discussing about the project and practical components of master's program in anthropology. So, because we keep getting calls from the learners regarding how to go about this practical and project component. So, in this video, I shall try to clear most of your doubts. Before going further, let me explain clearly about the credit system. This is a 2-year program with 64 credits, and the learner has to pass 8 credits, total of 8 credits, and then each course is of 8 credits. So, anthropology is a field science, and anthropology has been defined as the holistic study of human being, past, present, and future. So to understand holistically about the human being, we have included several courses. In the first year, we have included 4 basic courses. They are anthropology and methods of research, physical anthropology, social anthropology, and archaeological anthropology. These are the 4 basic courses that are available in the first year. However, in the first 2 courses, that is in anthropology and methods of research, there is theory as well as project component. And in the second course, physical anthropology, we have included theory and practical component. But in the remaining 2 courses, theory component is also available. Coming to the courses which are offered in the second year, there are 2 compulsory courses. They are practicing anthropology and fieldwork and dissertation. The course practicing anthropology is a compulsory course which has theory and project component. However, the fieldwork and dissertation is completely devoted for project component. There is no theory in it. And at present, we are offering 5 elective courses. These 2 learner has to select 2 courses among the 5 courses. The courses are human genetics, human growth and development, comparative ethnography, gender and society, and environmental anthropology. These are the 5 courses, elective courses, that are offering in the second year. So, in the human genetics course, we have practical component besides theory, and also in the course human growth and development, there is a practical component besides theory. Then, so I'll just explain what is the eligibility criteria, etc., etc. Any graduate from any stream is eligible to take admission into the master's program in anthropology, and at present the program is offered in English medium, and the duration of the program is 2 to 5 years, and the program is offered in both the cycles, July as well as in January cycles. IGNU provides to the learners the self-learning material in the form of eGang course, hard copy, that is printed material, and you can also download eContent app where you can access the course material. Then I'll just explain what is assignments, what is determined examination, etc. Assignments are available in the IGNU website under student zone. The students are expected to download the assignments from the website, IGNU website, and you have to write the assignment, submit to the regional center. In the case of assignments, no revaluation is allowed, and we also suggest you don't copy as it is from the course material. You are advised to read the course material, understand properly, and also read the material which is relevant to that topic, the other books and write the assignment and submit the assignments to the study center for evaluation. Regarding term end examination, the weightage of term end examination is 70%. However, the weightage for assignments is 30%. The weightage for project component is 30% and weightage for practical component is 30%. This weightage of 30% of project and practical component is a part of your term end examination theory. Then IGNO conducts examination twice in a year, that is June and December. Then coming to credit system, in IGNO we define credit system as one credit is equal to 30 hours of study hours. It includes all learning activities including reading and comprehending the course material, listening to audios, watching the videos, counseling sessions, teleconferencing, IRC, writing of the assignments, etc., etc. Then, coming to the main topic of today's is the project as well as practical component. Let us begin with project component. I stated in the beginning that this project component is available in three courses, that is anthropology and methods of research, practicing anthropology and fieldwork and dissertation. This anthropology and methods of research is in the first year, and practicing anthropology and fieldwork and dissertation are in the second year. All the courses are compulsory. So what you do, so I will just explain briefly what is the purpose of introducing this project in all the three courses is to familiarize the candidate with the research, because we wanted to introduce the students into the research. Once you complete your postgraduate program, you can go for MPhil or PhD program. So before that, we wanted to make some base for the student community by introducing this project component in three courses. Because since anthropology is a field science, we wanted to undertake rigorous fieldwork by student community, come back, sit, analyze the data, write the report and submit. So to make, to take up topics or to select a topic, the students are advised to select a topic from any of the three branches. So anthropology has basically four main branches: social anthropology, physical anthropology, archaeological anthropology and linguistic anthropology. The students can choose a topic either from social anthropology or physical anthropology or archaeological anthropology. Sometimes if you wish to do research in linguistic anthropology, you are also welcome. Or you can choose a topic combination of one or two sub-disciplines or sometimes three disciplines. So I am just giving you few examples of topic that can be taken up. Say for example, migration pattern among tribal and rural populations, health status of tribal communities, marriage pattern of tribal communities, kinship system in a particular caste community, and religious patterns of a particular community, health and hygiene in slums, tribal, rural and urban areas, and nutritional assessment of a community, understanding of the blood pressure variation between the two populations, or epidemiological studies, counseling studies. So you can take up any kind of study that will come under the domain of anthropology. Also, sometimes you can take up a study which is slightly allied disciplines. Then in practicing anthropology also, because it is in second year, you are already familiar with project work that you have done in the first year. So what I would suggest to you is you can take up a project which is more deeper when compared to the first year. So here also you can take up any kind of study. I suggest to you, because it is a practicing anthropology, is a topic which would be of applied oriented in nature from anthropological perspective. You can take up such kind of study and undertake a rigorous field work, come back, analyze the data and write the report. So here I will give you a few examples. Applications of physical anthropology and or applications of anthropometry or understanding of growth patterns in a particular population or blood group polymorphism in two populations or genetic polymorphism of two populations. If we have lab facilities, you can also take up studies on DNA polymorphism. Then this is the core fieldwork and dissertation. This course is completely devoted for project work. There is no theory in it. So we expect from the learners that you need to select a topic so that you can do more research in this project and come up with good results and submit the results to IGNU. So the basic queries that I am getting from the learners is, sir, how to prepare a project, how to submit a project, where to submit a project, how to get it evaluated, this kind of questions I am getting. So I am clearing all these doubts here. First, you have to select a topic or choose a mentor. The mentor may be a counselor or a person who is working in a degree college or university or any research institute or a freelance researcher who is qualified, who has required qualifications to guide you properly. You select a mentor and then select a topic, then sit with him, discuss about the topic, whether he is able to guide you properly or not. Then if he is able to guide you, then do literature review, proper literature review, so that you will get more literature on that. So then you write a synopsis. The synopsis includes introduction, maybe 1 to 2 pages, followed by objectives. What are the objectives that you wanted to study in this project? Then followed by methodology. What methods you are going to adopt? What is the techniques, technologies that you wanted to adopt but into use for this project? Then references. You just prepare a project by incorporating all these subheadings like introduction, aims and objectives, methodology and references. And I suggest you, please, references should be in the same format or uniform format. Once you are done with this synopsis, when you have satisfied with the synopsis that you have prepared, then there are three pro formas you need to fill them. One is pro forma for approval, which is available in all the three projects manuals. Take a photocopy it, fill it up properly, get it signed by your mentor, you also sign. The next pro forma is consent letter of the mentor. There is a pro forma in the project manual. Take a printout of that and or take a photocopy of that, get it signed by your mentor. And finally, we request you to provide us with simple bio data of the mentor, because we wanted to understand what is his qualification, what is his background of research, and where is he working. If he is not working, what is his freelance place and all that. So once you have completed your project synopsis and filled all these forms, the project synopsis along with these forms should be sent to the program coordinator, Masters in Anthropology program, School of Social Sciences, IGNU, Maidangadi, New Delhi. So after we received the synopsis from the learners, what we do here in the discipline, we check your synopsis, whether the synopsis is written properly or not, whether the supervisor is having sufficient qualifications or not, we check properly. And if everything is in the order, we approve and we send back the feedback letter to the candidate through speed post, or these days I am sending through WhatsApp or via email. Suppose if it is not approved, what we do, we give some comments. We advise the students to revise the synopsis and send us back. Once you send us back, we again recheck it by the same faculty which has been checked earlier, and we send you the approval pro forma. So once you have received the approval pro forma from the discipline, you can go ahead with your research work. Say for example, then you can go for the field work, collect the data, analyze the data, discuss with your mentor, take his suggestions, write the detailed report. So the detailed report includes introduction. You have to write a clear introduction and with review of literature, proper review of literature. What are the books you have referred? How many papers, research papers you have referred? How many journals you have referred? You have to refer there. And also you can give aims and objectives. What are the different aims and objectives of the particular study? Then coming to the methodology. What are the methods that you have employed in collecting the data, in analyzing data? Say for example, what are the statistical tools that you have employed? So mean, median, or mode, or regression analysis have you applied, or ANOVA have you applied, or some other statisticals if you have applied, you can describe them. Then you can write your results and discussion. What are the results? Then you have to discuss your results properly. Then you can give your references and bibliography. Afterwards, this is important. Regarding MANI-001 and MANI-003 courses, that is Anthropology and Methods of Research, Practicing Anthropology courses, you have to send the completed projects to the Registrar, Student Evaluation Division, IGNU, Maidan Gadi, New Delhi, 110068 for evaluation. But regarding the second year fieldwork dissertation course, the course code is MANP001. You are advised to send the completed project report to the regional director concerned. Regional director concerned because regional center will arrange for your evaluation of the project and conduct of YYOC and uploading of the marks. Then, so far we have discussed about the project component. Now, let us discuss about the practical component that is involved in the program. So, I stated in the beginning that this project component is involved in three courses. Physical anthropology in the first year, it is a compulsory course. Human genetics, human growth and development, these two are the optional courses in the second year. In these three courses, the practical component is involved. So these practicals would be conducted at the study center. The examinations would also be conducted at the study center concerned. So you have to attend for the practical sessions at your concerned study center, and in that practical sessions, 80% of the attendance is compulsory. And also you are advised to make a practical file. Now, let us briefly discuss about the practical component of the course physical anthropology. So we have three units. Unit number one, osteology and instruments used. So physical anthropology is a course which focuses on the biological understanding of human evolution and variation. To understand human evolution and variation, anthropometry is a tool, which is a basic tool, which has been used by anthropologists many years to understand these basic two aspects, that is variation and evolution. So before going further, first chapter is osteology and instruments. What is osteology? Osteology is nothing but a study of bones. What are the different bones that are in the human body? Like your long bones, your short bones, your irregular bones, your sesamoid bones, etc. And then we have described in detail what are the instruments that have been used in this practical, like anthropometric rod. It is a basic instrument that has been used by anthropologists. So, anthropometric rod, weighing scale, spreading caliper, sliding caliper, and skinfold caliper, and your measuring tape, and mandibulometer. So, we have clearly described the different instruments that are being used by anthropologists in this practical component. Then, we have described very clearly about anthropometry. Then, what is anthropometry? Anthropometry is the recording of measurements on living or a dead human being or on the bones. Anthropometry has been divided into two components, somatometry and craniometry. The somatometry is the recording of measurements on the living human being, but this craniometry is the recording of measurements on the bones, which includes your skull bones. Mandibulometry is another area where we record the measurements on the mandible. And we have included a small chapter on somatoscopy. This somatoscopy is nothing but visual observation of the human body, that is your skin color, your hair color, your hair structure, and epicanthic fold is there. Some population has a different fold, that is epicanthic fold. These are all the morphological characters that have been used in classification of human populations like Mongoloid, Negroid, Caucasoid, etc., etc. So these are the next chapter is physiological variables. Under this chapter, we have described our blood pressure, heart rate, and hemoglobin estimation. How to record the blood pressure with the help of sphygmomanometer and your stethoscope, and how to record the heart rate and how to estimate hemoglobin. So, by taking a drop of blood, we can estimate the hemoglobin in the laboratory. These three are useful in understanding the population variation. Next, we have a chapter on serology. In this serology, we have included a classical genetic marker, that is ABO blood group system, which has been widely used by anthropologists in understanding population variation. And lastly, there is one unit on dermatographics. Dermatographics is study of finger and palm prints. So, we have given a detailed description about the finger and palmar dermatographics in the project practical manual. So, you are advised to attend to the practical classes, and after the practical classes are over, you are supposed to write a project file, practical file, and submit to the study center for taking your practical examinations. Then, the next course which has practical component is human genetics. See, anthropology is human variation and evolution. So, to understand human evolution, we need gene frequencies. In the first year, in physical anthropology practicals, we have a serology in which blood group polymorphism was done. But in second year, we are including a chapter how to calculate gene frequencies from these ABO and RHA blood group systems. These gene frequencies are helpful in understanding the human evolution. There are different evolutionary forces, and by understanding gene frequencies of these two systems, we can understand the evolution of human being. And we have included PTC and color blindness. These are the genetical markers which has been used by anthropologists to understand human evolution. and these are the hereditary genetic characters. PTC is phenyl thiocarbamide test. Some people have tasting and some people doesn't have any taste. So the other one is color blindness. In this color blindness, some people cannot see few colors like red, green. And so with the help of Ishkiara charts, so anthropologists could able to distinguish a person can distinguish all the colors or not. The next, we have included a small chapter on hemoglobin typing by using electrophoresis. Electrophoresis is an equipment, and with the help of that electrophoresis, by using agarose gel, we can distinguish the hemoglobin type, that is fetal hemoglobin, adult hemoglobin, etc., etc. And finally, the third one is a demonstration of sickle cell hemoglobin from human blood. So sickle cell hemoglobin, which is prevalent in African populations. So we have included a chapter how to demonstrate the sickle cell hemoglobin from the human blood. And the lastly, there is one small chapter on molecular traits, where we have provided a clear, understanding of the extraction of DNA from the human blood. Then the last practical component of the course, of the three courses, is human growth and development. In this human growth and development, we included three chapters. One is anthropometry and description of various anthropometric measurements and shape growth ratios. So what we did was, in anthropometry, like that in the first year, in the physical anthropology practicals, because to undertake growth, human growth and development studies, understanding of anthropometry is more important. So here we have described clearly about anthropometry. Anthropometry is nothing but recording of measurements on the human body, whether living or dead, and it is of two types, somatometry and astrometry. Somatometry is the recording of measurements on the human living human being, and astrometry is the measurement of bones, including your skull bones. And here also we have described about different anthropometric measurements that have been used by anthropologists, like your anthropometer rod, skinfold caliper, sliding caliper, spreading caliper, tape, etc., etc. And finally, we have included a small chapter on shape growth ratios. A detailed presentation on different relative measurements is presented in that chapter. For example, relative sitting height vertex, or cephalic index, or nasal index. So by measuring different anthropometric measurements, we can assess the human growth of an individual or a population. Finally, if you have any doubts regarding the assignments or project component or practical component, or any doubts, if you have any doubts, you can visit our website, that is www.ignu.ac.in, or regional center websites for regular updates. Or regarding anthropology program, you can please write a mail. My email IDs are there, and my email ID is available in the IGNU website. You can mail it to me, or you can call me. I will respond to your mails, as well as your WhatsApp messages or phone calls. So I am always available, and all the best. Thank you so much for listening to me patiently. Yeah.